Hey, YouTube. It's Wednesday on Queering Feminism. This week we're discussing feminist myths, and the male feminist. I'm sitting in my childhood home on these lovely cross stitches that my mother did. She's very talented. I mean, really, she's amazing. So feminist myths. What to say? I think Sue touched on a lot of the really substantive ones. Like, not all feminists are lesbians. Feminists don't all hate men. And those are, you know, really important, because I think they're kind of lobbed as counter-arguments. But I think there's other myths that are equally as pervasive, but aren't necessarily counter-arguments. But they're myths. Such as all feminists are ugly. Like, okay, hello, have you seen her channel? That answers that myth right there. What else? Feminists don't shave their underarms. I think I've heard that before. Feminists don't wear bras. All feminists burn bras. All feminists are angry. It's a weird one. I think, you know, my friend Des on Thursdays, she's probably one of the happiest people I've met. So, her being a feminist, I don't think, you know, if she's angry about something, it's probably, like, a legit reason. It's not just because she's a feminist. But, you know, being a feminist can make you angry sometimes, because there is still ignorance and weirdness out there. I always thought that was a weird myth, that all feminists are angry. You know, there's the feminazi label. Like, you know, feminists are these angry, intense people who just want everyone to, like, follow the capital W woman and don't pay attention to men anymore. Oh, no. Which really brings me to the next, section of this week's topic, is the male feminist. Obviously, don't know if you can tell, stand up, turn around a little bit, sit back down. As you can see, I'm a male. I'm not going to definitively prove it to you, because I think YouTube would take down my video. but I am a male. And I am a feminist. And that is something that has caused controversy in other people's lives, being male and being feminist. Some people might think that males want to be feminists because they get chicks. Obviously, that's not my... being that this is queering feminism, that's obviously not my MO. That's not my objective here. Some might say men want to be feminists because they're emasculated, which is funny because it's, you know, sort of going against the whole feminist movement anyway. This idea of emasculation by associating with women or championing women's causes or something, you know, that's ridiculous. And I think, if a man, both, you know, gay, straight, you know, even a transgender man, feels as though gender shouldn't be a qualifier for what one chooses in their life, shouldn't be a qualifier for what one feels is their goal, or is their, life's path, then I think that their voices should be heard in the feminist movement. And if these people recognize that, you know, women and the feminine, which Sue very astutely pointed out is different than being a woman, femininity is different from, you know, necessarily being a woman, that the feminine and the woman have been sort of downtrodden, put in an inferior position throughout history. I think if, you know, these people recognize that, then, you know, sure, come along. Come with, you know, the movement, because it's, it's one of those movements where it seems as though it's hard for some people to really understand what's going on, really understand the tenets of, you know, grievances, I guess. Some people think, like, oh, you know, women can work now, you know, there's no need for feminism because there's no such thing, you know, women are being forced to live at home anymore. Okay. Maybe in some places, other places maybe not. And to be quite honest, while there are still issues that feminism addresses in America, feminism is much even still about, you know, the world. There's still plenty of women, like, female oppression throughout the world, and shouldn't feminism exist for those people as well? And, you know, still exist to address the issues that are in our society as, you know, at the same time. So, you know, if males are willing to open themselves up to this, to lend their voices to this movement, I don't think this should be discriminated against. There are feminists out there that do think that males don't have a whole lot to offer because they don't have a male or female experience. But that's ridiculous, because there's no such thing as one female experience. All females experience different things. That's kind of the point of feminism, is that being a woman, being a female, doesn't necessarily qualify your life one way or the other. So, that's what I think. Oh, and watch Dez tomorrow.